The star season is only a month old, but it feels like it's at a pivotal point. During a difficult stretch, Dallas has been searching for wins. And before time slips away, the Stars have to find a way to turn things around. Some changes have been made, but the belief remains that inside the room, the answers lie within. Now it's about proving it to themselves and the rest of the hockey world. And tonight comes the latest opportunity. Three-game homestand comes with a pretty bright spotlight as the Stars welcome in the Philadelphia Flyers on Dallas Stars Hockey, presented by Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant. It's been a reflective few days since the Stars last left the ice, and tonight, Jamie Benn and company try and claw their way out of an early season slump and back into the win column. Hi there, everybody, and a very good evening to you. Welcome to Dallas Stars Hockey alongside Daryl Ray. I'm Josh Bogorod. Stars, it's only been 72 hours since they last played a game, but a lot's happened since then. And when you digest all of it, Razor, and you head into this one tonight, where is this Stars team?
Well, in some trouble if things don't change here, right? It's the type of opening month that can shake you to your core. And when you sit near the bottom of the National Hockey League with this group, it stuns some people. And that's where they sit right now. Near the bottom in record, goals for, goals against. That's a bad equation. Their goal differential, their penalty killing has been leaky. Their second period's crippling. A players-only meeting, a long one. The roster has been jarred a little bit. And youth, speed, skill, and the potential for some offense has been elevated from the American Hockey League. Jacob Peterson and Riley Tufte are up and in here tonight. Peterson started the season with the Stars, scored the first goal of the season, looked good, went down for a couple of weeks. He's back. He'll play with Sagan and Radulov to begin. Riley Tufte makes his NHL debut. First round pick in 2016. He has size. He can skate. He can get to the net. He can help. Both of them can help. But it's about everybody in that room. You know, it has to transfer from words and a little jar to the roster to how they compete on the ice here.
And they'll take aim on a Philadelphia Flyers team that's off to a pretty good start. They won last night. Impressive victory against the NHL's top team in Carolina. And Stars didn't see this team last year, but if you followed them, they entered that year with high expectations. Did not meet them. Fell out of the playoffs, so they overturned about half their roster. What's working for them this year?
Well, it's not goal production. It's goal prevention, right? They're right about where they were last year as far as goals scored are concerned, but the improvements defensively are startling. The goals against average better by over a goal. The save percentage is phenomenal at .931. It was terrible last season. In goal, Carter Hart has refound his form. He played last night. And Martin Jones so far has refound his game. Signed as a free agent after a couple of sub-seasons with San Jose. He's 3-0 as a Flyer. And although it's a small sample size, he owns the best goals against average and the best save percentage in the entire NHL. So if they're struggling to score goals, it doesn't seem like it's going to be any easier against the Flyers tonight.
Well, while scoring has been a struggle overall, it hasn't been the case on the power play. Stars have one of the...
Anton Khudobin looks effulgent and nefarious in his blackout paraphernalia. He looks awesome. Stars need him to play awesome here tonight. You know about the guy at the other end. Good matchup in the pipes, and here we go.
Face off at center ice. The puck is dropped or underway, and the Stars begin with the line of Jamie Benn centering Michael Raffel and Denis Gurianov. This was a line that was together when training camp opened. Benn, of course, at center. He's seen spot duty there to open up this year. It's been mostly at wing. We'll see how they set the tone. It's Miro Heiskanen playing it up ahead, intended for Raffel. Spent 8 seasons in a Flyers sweater. It was cut off and whistled down 28 seconds in.
Rick Bonus seemed to reassert his head coach authority at practice yesterday. He was pretty much the only voice. Been very open to empowering assistants in pass, but with the final say always. And yesterday, he was on point. They were crisp. Now they got to back it up here tonight.
Dumped in by Dallas. Martin Jones, longtime goaltender for the San Jose Sharks here in Philly, getting the net in the second night of a back-to-back. Sprung ahead looking for Atkinson. Rolls in on Khudobin, and he will hang on to it. Let's head down to Michelle McMahon.
Josh, thanks so much. We've got to get things going here, and we've got to do it quickly. That was the overall sentiment of the players-only team meeting after Wednesday night's loss that lasted over 30 minutes long. These guys told me that it's not only about the playoffs at this point, it's also to do with pride. Ryan Suter says, we haven't been good. Everyone knows that we just need to get back to the basics, guys.
Yeah, definitely. Just 13 games into this season now as Hudobin hangs on to another one. There's just a different feeling surrounding this game and what Dallas needs to do and get out of it.
Well, I mean, they need to play faster together and they need to play harder longer. It's as simple as that. We talked about it the other night. It's the same thing. You need to get better goaltending performance than your guy, than their guy. Better special teams from your special teams than their special teams. You can win a lot of hockey games that way.
Flyers control, shot by Yandle. That deflects to the corner. There's a lot of new faces to this Philadelphia lineup. They got nine guys who were not part of the team last year. Nate Thompson, he's one of them, catches up. Thompson was a deadline acquisition just before the COVID pause in 2020. Found his way back here in the offseason after spending a year in Winnipeg. Dangerous there, nearly giveaway by Hudobin, and the Stars come away with it.
He gives them some help on the side of the puck. They need help, and they're showing on the defensive side of things.
It's Alexander Radulov looking for Jacob Peterson. A return after his AHL debut. He was successful down there, so too was Riley Tufte. One hand by Couturier went through and wide, then a shot caroms its way to Rasmus Ristolainen. Former Sabre came over in the offseason trade. Couturier going to work. Moves it up high. Sanheim, the big wind and fire. And it bounces in the corner. Everybody had lost sight of it. Hit the netting. And gains the whistle.
Well, the Flyers have come out with their namesake here tonight. Flying Alain Vigneault, their head coach. Was a head coach in Montreal, Vancouver, New York, and now Philadelphia. Last year was an absolute aberration for a Vigneault coach team. Just abysmal defending. Always well-organized play with just exquisite balance between their offensive game and their defensive game, and equally proficient at home and on the road. That's what his teams have always been about, and they weren't last year at all.
Tyler Seguin was out there to help win this faceoff with Raffle and Ben. The Stars do, and they're able to get it out to center. So Seguin heads to the bench, and Gurianov jumps on. Here's Ryan Ellis. Rejoined play, just his fourth game of the season. Weird to see him in orange and white. He wears number 94 for the Flyers. Came over in the three-team deal. Spent the first 10 years, of course, with the Nashville Predators. Now Gurianov will dump it in. Jones cuts it off. Wrapped around, and Stars had a chance to keep it in. It's out to center, and Esselindell presses pause there. Early stages, 2.5 gone by. No score. Stars and the Flyers. First of two meetings this year. Travis Konechny will take a tip. And Hudobin spins it around, cut off by Derek Brassard. Brassard goes low. Konechny banks it to Braun. Shot stopped. Robertson tried to flip it ahead for Hintz. He'll bat it to Pavelski. Splits a pair. He's in. Pavelski shot saved by Jones.
And strong play by Joe Pavelski. Rope Hansen neutralized to spring that.
Another shot turned aside by Jones. Hintz goes low for Pavelski. Early opportunity for Dallas after Pavelski just forced his way in. Suter chips in on the backhand. Behind the net, Jones spun around. Alexander Radulov behind the cage. Radulov turns to the forehand, flipped it over to Seguin. Peterson, third man on that line. He's in the right circle. Pass couldn't get across. Net front. Jam at it. And it's taken by Thompson and clear. And knocked out of midair with a high stick. Played, and it's whistled.
This is one of those little delay plays in neutral ice after the one-timer attempt by Braun, and then it's broken up. Strong play there, just a little bump play. And a swerve by Pavelski. How many times have we seen this, though? They get a quality scoring opportunity early in a game, chance to get a lead, and they get stoned by the guy in the mask at the end of the rink. Good stop by Martin Jones.
Here's Haskinen. He'll cut down the right side, try to flip a backhand pass. Provorov cut it off. Then it catches a stick, falls to the circle, bunted out to center ice. Flyers stretch it out. Couturier in front of the Dallas bench. Lost a handle, had some support. Stars get it near the line. Second effort, they'll clear it. Provorov tosses back in. Both teams in the midst of a change. Dallas is Luke Glendening. Glendening here on this fourth line with Radek Foxa and Riley Tufte. It's Van Riemsdyk entering. Stars take it away, Klingberg. Tufte wearing number 27, NHL debut for the first rounder from 2016. It's hard to miss, he's 6'6".
Can't help but think of all the young guys that came in to the lineup last year and scored their first goal in this uniform.
Yeah. I was thinking the same thing. The script is practically writing itself.
It's like, go ahead. Do it in the Skyline Green blackouts.
There's Sandheim. Defenseman carries back in for Philadelphia. Down the right side. Centered it through the crease. Got around to the far wing and then poked out. Ope hints there. Trying to drag with it off the board. Just Pavelski back in. It's Hayes making his season debut. Kevin Hayes was just activated earlier today off of LTIR. Had abdominal surgery back before the season got underway.
Also had some tragedy they had to deal with.
Heartbreaking story. The loss of his brother, Jimmy.
Who was just absolutely beloved by anybody that knew him. That is, obviously he's playing for him.
Inside the Philadelphia end. Puck is taken away by the Flyers, trying to spring it up ahead. Now Konechny will get it in deep. Long stretch here without a whistle. Over 6 minutes gone by in the first.
It's been frantic at times, which is good and bad. You know, like it shows intensity and effort, but you want to do what you do together, collectively, and under control.
Ristolainen hit by Foxa. Puck. Glendening tried to get it out for Tufte. He had company there. It was tied up. The other way come the Flyers across the line. Lindblom and Thompson spun it around. Stars intercept. Poke from the center line. And they'll make a wholesale change.
Watch the Flyers play. They like to get their D-men to just pound pucks toward the net. They're a funnel offense a lot of the time. Send guys in that general vicinity. Saw it earlier with that try by Braun to get it on net immediately. Just get the defensive side of things off balance a bit.
At center ice, Keith Yandle. Fake it, and Giroux goes back for Yandle. Long pass to neutral. Area pass goes back to Giroux. He's in his 10th year as Flyers captain. He's an unrestricted free agent at the end of the season. Gurianov with a shot that rattles up and out of play. Under 13 to play in the first. Scoreless here on a Saturday night in Big D.
The Stars and Flyers, our Taco Bell take tonight. 2 years ago, the Stars faced the Flyers in a similar funk. They were 1-7-1 out of the gate, tying for the worst start in Stars history. They beat the Flyers 4-1 in Philly. And that slump buster started a run that saw the Stars win 14 of 16. Can it happen again?
False start on this draw, so we'll do it again. Anybody who was around for that turnaround with the Stars, they've heard about 1-7-1. It almost became a mantra so many times. It's not a situation you want to find yourself in. You still hope that you can draw from it, draw from experience. Because Giroux is going to...
There's going to be a penalty, I think, two faceoff violations in a row.
Dallas, minor penalty, delay a game, faceoff violation.
I think that's the second time since they instituted that rule we've seen that with the Stars. It's almost never called. That's offensive zone, and that's a tough pill to swallow.
Well, Roope Hintz was the first guy in there. He got kicked out. That's fine. You get one of those, and then Pavelski went in, flinched. Something went wrong on that, and the Stars find themselves shorthanded. This has been a problem area for the Flyers this season offensively, and it's not been good. Neither is the Stars' penalty killing, though.
Stars were just shorthanded one time in their last game Wednesday against Nashville. Flyers 0 for 10 in their last three games, just 1 for 19 in their last half dozen. Khudobin gloves down and he hangs on to it. Alexander Radulov is serving the minor for the Stars.
Yeah, and a penalty like that, you send somebody in the box that doesn't kill penalties for you, and Radulov doesn't kill for the Stars. They really want to be smart, aggressive with their penalty killing, and obviously get saves. One of the referees is going over to the corner where the Ice Girls are. He's only summoned one Ice Girl. Singular. She goes flying down the ice with the shovel. And they have, wow, that's a lot of buildup of ice for 7 minutes into a hockey game along the boards. She gets the same lap that Riley Tufte got in warm-up tonight, the single lap. Maybe she's one of the rookie Ice Girls. I don't know.
Well, they've got that taken care of. Is that like when there's a bench
minor? I've never ever seen that.
You get to pick the Ice Girl of your choice to come out and do it? Like that's the version of Radulov there. So we're back to action. Face-off violation penalty against the Stars. The rarely whistled. It'll bounce in. Doesn't quite get to Dobin. Batted to the corner. Should be smooth down there. Held in by Yandel up at the line. Yandel over to Giroux. Goes low. Touched by Van Riemsdyk. Went through the crease and won.
JVR is one of the better deflectors in the game around the net. Big lanky guy can get his stick on those shots from the point.
Here's Claude Giroux, wide fires. It was blocked by Lindell and cleared by the Stars.
It's good work. Esa Lindell and Jamie Benn on that side of the ice. It really wasn't a lane to the net.
You mentioned the penalty killing woes this season for the Stars. It has cost them early on this year. They're only 75%. Bottom third of the NHL. Ryan Ellis, he should help this Philadelphia power play, just his fourth game of the year, but it's picked up and cleared all the way down.
There have been some herky-jerky plays with pucks just sitting there in front of Khudobin that the Flyers have not been able to get to.
Here's Atkinson, right circle, and his shot just missed.
He can blister it from the wing, too.
Career Columbus Blue Jacket came over from Voracek in the offseason. Break wide, it deflected off the Dallas stick in on Khudobin, who had to be alert, turning the shot. 20 left on the power play. Shot caroms its way to the near corner. Hayes is on it there. Flips it to Ellis. Ellis left wing side. Provorov a shot. Save made. Khudobin. Under 10 seconds left on the power play. Ellis at the point. Slides it. Provorov high slot. Now Hayes a shot. He didn't get everything he wanted on it. Khudobin eats it up as time expires and Radulov exits the sin bin.
Well, the seldom called penalty, and it doesn't cost the Stars. I think it's a bit of a junky penalty anytime. It's in the book and all that. It's like goaltenders handling it where they can't. Flyers had the puck in the zone almost the entirety of it. And right at the buzzer of the minor penalty, Hayes was wide open. He did not get much of that, and it's a good thing as Khudobin got across on his knees. Smothered, settled. They get a restart to his left, which is important.
Jamie Benn, and he was going to take it against Lott. He gets kicked out, so
careful.
Careful, Travis.
Guys are going to be... Rigor mortis is going to set in on the second guy on faceoffs for a while here now.
They set their bar, as you'd imagine. Benn wins it cleanly. Lawton played it and goes right to Benn. All the way down it goes. Jones turned over in the corner. It's Radulov. Loose puck near side. Suter had slipped down the boards. Couldn't get there in time. So he's just trying to roadblock Ristolainen. Comes out across the line. Klingberg had to be worried about a defensive posture in the Stars regroup. Ryan Suter. Pass tipped by Sagan. Jones over to Ristolainen. Awkward hop off the corner boards. Goes to Justin Braun. And Klingberg tied up in front of the Dallas bench, swiped out. Philly's making a change. They had to be careful to let it go, and they did. Over halfway through this first period, no score between the Stars and the Flyers. Roope Hintz, he comes in with speed. Hintz and Robertson. Robertson shoots, saved by Jones. And then he put it from a tight angle, caromed off.
He's going to catch a lot of goaltenders in his career admiring their first save. Almost did there.
Sekera from the red line. Andre Sekera is back in. Thomas Harley was sent down as part of the roster lineup shuffling. Back to the American Hockey League. So Sekera returns to play. Go along with the two forwards who were recalled from the AHL. Lifted in by Van Riemsdyk. Sekera in the corner. Giroux gets it first. Giroux centering feed. Clanked around in the circles. Good stick poked away by Robertson. Hustled to get there. Stars in trouble. High slot shot and a glove save. Couturier denied by the left hand of the sharp-looking Anton Khudobin. No score between the Stars and the Flyers. Just under nine remaining in the first.
Minutes remaining in the opening period here at American Airlines Center. Stars and Flyers scoreless. Our fourth leaderboard tonight. Apropos, you might say, after that penalty we just saw. It's the best face-off teams in the NHL. The Flyers and Stars are perennially two of the best. They sit 3-4 this season. You need centers with pride in the skill. Stars are drumming them on the dots to start the game tonight. They've won 7 of the first 9. The only one they fouled up, they ended up shorthanded out of and killed the penalty.
I was going to say, it was definitely going to be 8 of 10 because they were jumping early to win that one.
Flyers had a tough time in Carolina last night winning faceoffs, too. And Carolina's the best faceoff team, so maybe no shock there.
Ryan Ellis, edge of the trapezoid, sends it around the high glass. Logged on the wall. Atkinson and Lindell tie up. Bounces its way to center. Joel Farabee, he got back on the board last night. One of the two goals for Philly. Farabee in his third year. He had a breakout year last year, led him in scoring. He has turned into a very good young player. Yandel around, hops over to Peterson. He gets tripped up right in front of the referee. Play goes on. Crowd disagrees. Yandel and Radulov. Peterson steps in. Fed it from the circle through the low slot. Stars jump on it there. Klingberg. Given away to Konechny. Opank at the safety, off for Brassard. Longtime veteran, back to Konechny. He's in across the Dallas line. Low shot goes wide. Lawton sends it back around. Ristolainen down into the corner. Ristolainen cutting to the net. And hit the side of it.
And it looked like Khudobin had left his short side pipe.
The other way, Gurianov gets the legs moving. He cuts to the net. Save made by Jones. Looked like he caught Lindblom in no man's land. Suter. Klingberg. Shot blocked by Lindblom. Gurianov shot. Stopped in the slot.
Lindblom did the right thing. Turn around as a forward and chase. Ristolainen just took a high stick in the face. All these things uncalled, but they got the faceoff violation.
The only penalty so far, Suter with a shot. Rising wrister, found the glass.
Just about found the ear on Gurianov.
Suter to the right wing. Shot by Foxa, one time. Back around for Klingberg. Skates to the center of the zone. Right side, it was in skates. So Suter goes back up top for Klingberg. Klingberg shot, tip, score! Glendening gets the redirection, his fourth of the year, and gives Dallas the lead.
As high as a Detroit Red Wing was a dozen. He's on a 20-plus goal pace. That's a goal scorer's deflection. Sometimes you have to plow around the stump, and there was no shot lane. Everybody was between John Klingberg and goaltender Martin Jones, so
The always alert Klingberg finds a stick blade, perfectly deflected upstairs, and the Stars do have a lead on home ice.
Anton Khudobin had to make 10 saves on 10 Philadelphia shots to keep this game scoreless. Poked the other way, Clint Denning, almost another redirection. This one into the glove of Jones, and what a start here in Dallas for Glenn Denning.
Well, I mean, he was brought in primarily for his ability to kill penalties, win faceoffs, block shots, compete really hard. Well, he's done that as a Dallas Star, but the offense feels like a major bonus. And, I mean, they're not accidental. You know, they're going to the right areas and nice hand-eye coordination. Stars are going to end up shorthanded here again, though.
Another delayed call, so Philadelphia controls. Jones ready to head to the bench. Extra attacker until Dallas touches it. Provorov lays it off, and now across for Braun. He'll headman it for Farabee. They'll go back for Provorov. Six Flyers skaters. Robertson touches it. And with 5:55 left in the first, Pavelski heads to the box. We head to break. Luke Glendening. Four goals in 13 games with the Stars, and his latest has Dallas in front.
5:55 to go in the first. Stars up on the Flyers 1-0. Number 35 has sparkled here. Gonna have to continue doing so for the next couple of minutes as the Stars are shorthanded again. Stop the ones you're supposed to, a couple that maybe you shouldn't. He's doing that.
Pavelski in the box for high sticking, second power play.
Boy, another faceoff win. They are just dominating that stat. It's really emphasized on special teams.
Flyers had four shots on goal on their first power play. Again, Dallas doesn't allow an entrance.
Scored by number 11, Luke Glendening.
Well, Philadelphia in across the line. They went 0-for-5 last night in Carolina, and that included more than a minute's worth of 5-on-3 time. The Stars saw on that Canadian road trip, as it's clogged up here against the wall, a team in Vancouver that was struggling on the power play, and they got healthy because of too many opportunities against. It's a trap Dallas doesn't want to fall into here tonight. Farabee sends it back up high, then gets it down the wing. Continues a game of catch with Yandle. Slid over to Giroux. Both Giroux shot. Save Khudobin. He looked behind him, but he had it there in those blackout pads.
Not a lot of movement of people, the movement of puck, but not a lot of people moving around on the Flyer power play. It's perfect for Khudobin and the Stars penalty killing. Just lock on things, very strict with their movement. Khudobin's been fairly tidy with his rebound control. He was amusing this morning. He talked about how he hates black gear. Well, just focus on the skyline green then, Khudobin. Don't worry about the black stuff. For good reason, though, you do lose the puck in black equipment and jerseys.
He's been practicing with them in advance of the two games that they've worn the blackout sweaters. He gets the call tonight. If you're just joining us, Braden Holtby ruled out day-to-day. Earlier today, they summoned Jake Ottinger, who's serving backup duty.
Where the Flyer power play is deflating them a little bit here on their second opportunity of the night.
Atkinson is in, moves it to Ellis. Swung to the left side. Provorov banks it up top for Ellis. His shot, redirection, trickles off the glove of Khudobin. He gets back into position as the puck is in the corner, and then he gets the glove on it as it squirts back his way.
What a spectacular sprawling stop this is from Khudobin on a tough one. There are multiple Flyers right in front of the net. Ellis finds the shooting lane. He's looking for a stick, just like Klingberg did at the other end on Glendening's goal. And just nice multitasking by Khudobin. That is a shot looking for a tip. Found it. It was elevated. And Khudobin had to put on his gloves and kind of fight off both the puck and the Flyer forward right in front, Brassard, and keep it 1-0.
Key faceoff, glove side of Khudobin, Drew and Ben. And it is won by the Flyers this time. Ellis Couturier in the corner. Giroux sent it now in front, and it's deflected up and out of play. Ryan Suter was there and just saved a goal, perhaps, with his play on Van Riemsdyk.
Yeah, it's a great read by Suter, but it shows the aggression of the Stars' penalty kill. You know, as soon as it went down low, John Klingberg jumps. And when he jumps from his position in front of Hudobin, somebody has to collapse in behind. He goes in there. Suter's in front. He collapses on his guy. And although they were looking for the triangle quick puck movement, knifed out of harm's way by the veteran rear guard.
Movement early on this faceoff again. So we will do it again. It's Glenn Denning against Giroux. 8 seconds left in the power play. Flyers win it. They'll look for one late look here on this man advantage. Ellis, left wing circle. Wrist shot up high. Bounced off of Hudobin. Damn, caught him bottom of the mask. Out of the box comes Pavelski. So the Stars get through it. 0 for 2 Philadelphia. They'll keep the puck in the zone. 5 on 5 now. Wrist the line it. Rims it around. Off the stick of Couturier. Klingberg will just lift it to safety. Suter. Shovels ahead on the backhand for Glenn Denning. And off the body and into the Flyers bench.
Well, this is what you need. I mean, this isn't the recipe that you want to go with. You know, get outshot by a 2-1 margin again here on home ice. But it's penalties that are derailing some good stuff they have going on. This has happened a lot this season, unfortunately. The difference tonight so far is that there is no fruition offensively for the other team's power play. Thanks in large part to the guy in the pipes.
Icing here against Philadelphia, so we'll come back into the Flyer zone.
He knows it too. You know, you have a young guy just got called up as your backup. The guy you were platooning with is out of the lineup and injured right now. Like, you got to make a stand, and it looks like Hudobin is.
Miro Heiskanen, stutter step move to the high slot. Shot! Caught the right arm of Jones. Heiskanen is on a 3-game point streak. He's the Stars' leading scorer, and he continues to just be so confident, as you'd imagine. See him dance his way from the blue line and in. Now it's the Flyers who control. Konecny, back door! And Sanheim, it's denied! They reacted like they had scored. Hudobin kept it out. The music here even came on as if the opponent scored at American Airlines Center. And Hudobin's best of the night came right there.
Well, there's plenty of pylon orange in the building here tonight. And, yeah, he turned away with the idea that had gone. Shooters can lose it in all the blackness as well. Full split from Hudobin. Trapped it, I believe, under his pad. That's why you stretch at that position. Up top, it looked like Tyler Seguin got picked. And then a defenseman went down, backdoor play, half celebration, little premature, as Hudobin is in full Kazakhstani stunner mode here tonight. And they've needed it.
Travis Sanheim was staring up along with everybody here at the big board, seeing a replay of that, wondering how in the world he didn't just score his first goal.
Well, now they're going to have a look at it, I guess. I mean, it went into the blackness. You know, it goes into the darkness.
Yeah, so they're going to review this one. From the looks that we got on the TV side, it didn't seem like there was anything that could showcase that this would be called a goal.
See, now Dobie doesn't like the black, but sometimes the black is your friend.
This is an unintended consequence of this. Everybody loses sight in the black, and it hasn't hurt him one bit. He is 14 of 14.
It was a sweet pass through everyone, and if Sanheim elevates it in tight instead of trying to go between his legs, I think it is 1-1. You know, the question would be, where does it end up? Is it in the crook of his arm and his pad? And can you find any of it? I think that was a hopeful half celebration into the corner from Sanheim.
Meanwhile, Brassard was the net front guy just outside the crease. He went full celebration. It's almost like a play that develops and you just expect it's going to find the back of the net before it even leaves his stick. He's explaining it to his teammates.
No, he's getting grief over there. What were you doing celebrating?
So they look at it on the tablet in the penalty box, and they're in conference with the situation room in Toronto on bigger screens, trying to help them out and figure out whether this is still a goose egg for Dobie. Continues to shake his head. No, didn't go in.
This is where I wish we had done mic'd up just to get the inner thoughts of what he's thinking about. But they needed a performance like this from whoever was going to be between the pipes. And so far, he has delivered 17 minutes.
Goaltending can fix a lot of things.
After further review, the call on the ice stands. We have no goal.
There you go. Yeah. Double acknowledgement of the phantasmagoric stop by Anton Hudobin. Bam.
So play will resume to his right. Faceoff win, Thompson. Collected by Provorov. He'll work behind the net. Try and shed Hintz. Then he winds up down on a knee. Pops back up. Puck was right there. Back to Kuehn in the corner. He scored his first goal with the Flyers last night. Turned out to be a tie-breaking game winner midway through the third period in Carolina.
He's kind of their team cop. Can get around the rink.
Hintz. Sekera. One-time bid was blocked by Thompson. Sent to the corner. Braun is on it there. He goes to Provorov. Clearing attempt is gloved down. Now Thompson's got it. Flipped off a stick. Comes right back to him. The veteran will move it to Braun. Braun put it behind the net instead of in front of it for a couple of Thompson. Reached by Yanni Hakanpää. And then it eluded Sekera. Sekera has been scratched the last four games.
And he had a rough one against the Ottawa Senators. But that's a tough life to live, though, when you want to get right back out there and make do for what you did wrong. Then you got to sit and stew for a while. It's like being a backup goalie.
Scooped by Hudobin, who hangs on to it. And he has played that role phenomenally here tonight. He said he didn't find out until 7 p.m. last night he was going to start this game.
Well, it's the greatest blackout kit ever that he's rocking tonight. And I always believe if you look good, you play good. And he looks sensational. And he's backed it up with play on that par.
Does that go on the walk into the rink?
And all of it, Josh.
Morning to game time.
That's a big part of swagger.
Face-off win, Flyers. Here's Sanheim. Shot. Turned aside by Hudobin. Less drama to that one. Klingberg will take his time. Outlet it. Misses Gurianov. Race for the puck. And Ristolainen wins it. So it's icing against the Stars.
Stars have had their way with most of the faceoffs in the game. But the Flyers are pushing back here late in the period. And they get a chance off of this one. The ease at which the Stars gave this up. Sanheim, the guy who thought he scored, slips past a check on the boards. They couldn't kill the play there, and it turns into a mini mosh in front of Hudobin.
Another face-off win by the Flyers. Under a minute and a half to go now in the first period. The shots a little bit better than 2-1 for Philadelphia. They've had two power plays to aid that. The only goal belongs to Dallas. Another save made by Hudobin on a redirection. Klingberg gets pinned up by Couturier. Fight for the puck. Flyers come away with it. Up high at the line, swung near side, Braun, and it's gloved by Anton Hudobin, who just looks very, very comfortable and confident back there.
Yeah, I mean, the difference on the shot clock are the two power plays and the power play shots that they were able to build up on those. 5-on-5, it's pretty much been an even period, but that said, you look up and it's another period in which the Stars get smoked on the shot clock. I mean, smoked.
Flyers approaching 20, only a minute left. Konechny, a wraparound save! Hudobin got his right pad out. I'm not sure if Konechny was able to turn the corner and get that in off of him.
I don't think so. I don't know that he's long enough to be able to do that. He was in the right spot, but he tried.
Sanheim down into the corner. And a centering pass stopped by the skates of Sagan. Radulov hits the brakes, looking for Sagan. And dump it in from the red line. It's over a half minute to go in this first period. 1-0 Stars. Lawton chance to clear. He didn't. Forced out. Brassard ran himself into Haskinen. Then bounces wide of Hudobin's net. Both teams were changing, so Esa Lindell controlled breakout. Walk it out, put it on the tape of Ben. Right wide, Haskinen lost the handle. Here's a 2-on-1. It's Nate Thompson. Left circle, in front, saved by Hudobin. Rebound is behind the net. Only a few seconds left in the period. A prayer from a tight angle goes wide, and one final bullet dodged by the Stars in the closing seconds. And what a frame for that man.
Well, I mean, they can thank their netminder that they're not down by a few here in the opening period. And the Stars made some mental errors as the period went along. They got sloppy. That wind around, I don't know if it would have ever went in. He was still in behind, but I think it went off the toe of Hudobin, who made 19 saves to preserve one goal for an intermission lead for the Stars that is a mere miracle here after 20 minutes.
It is the most shots the Stars have allowed in a first period this season. But through it all, Anton Hudobin has Dallas in front at the intermission break. Glendening the goal, a whole lot of Anton. 1-0 Stars through 20 minutes in Dallas. First intermission report comes your way next.
Expansion now open, stakes raised. Frontier Fiber Optic, ranked in the top 5 fastest fiber internet in America. And by your Texas Ford dealers. Ford is the best in Texas.
One nothing Stars after one here in Dallas on top of the Philadelphia Flyers. Fans, don't miss Military Night with the Stars. Help us honor our military men and women on Tuesday night when the Stars take on the Detroit Red Wings at 7:30 p.m. The first 8,000 fans will receive a Stars camo cap presented by City Credit Union. You can get your tickets at DallasStars.com. And when the Red Wings are in town, that will be Luke Glendening's old team, and Luke Glendening is off to a terrific start for the Stars. He's got the only goal, but really, Razor, the main reason they're up is because at the other end, what Anton Hudobin has done.
Yeah, that was a disturbingly terrific opening period, right? They're up 1-0 on the Glendening goal, but, man, they gave up an awful lot of opportunities to the Philadelphia Flyers in the first 20 minutes. Hudobin is obviously the difference. He's usually better when he's busier, and he was a busy boy in the opening period. He had an answer for everything. His tracking was excellent. He's always quick and acrobatic in and around the net. And he had his battle game at its best in the first period here tonight. A couple of goal line stands for him. Just fabulous net binding. Our Dell Technologies control. 19 shots, 19 saves in the opening period. Reminded me a little bit of the game in Calgary. The only game the Stars have won in the last 7, and Hudobin played well early in that one, and they were able to upend the Calgary Flames in overtime 4-3.
So here as the second period begins, it will do so 5-on-5. And it's a period where the Stars all season long, for so many years, they were a second period team. Not the case this year. They've been outscored, a goal differential of minus 11 in middle frames. Taken a lot of penalties, they've gotten into a lot of problems, and certainly with a 1-0 lead, looking for a different outcome to this period, en route to a different outcome in the game. And Reamsdyke will chip it in on the backhand. We're underway here in the second. Haskinen out for Raffle, then off a stick, Jamie Benn tried to corral, he couldn't. Giroux off the stick of Raffle. Couturier will tap it in. Hudobin leaves in the trapezoid for Haskinen. They'll move it around to Ben. Hand off Gurionov with speed across the line. Denis Gurionov slices at the boards, then plays the cross. Shot by Klingberg. Hit the glass. The other way. Farabee brings in for Philly. Van Riemsdyk, a wrister. That just wide of the glove side. And back and forth we go.
Couple of chances off the rush. First period was mostly cycling.
Robertson is looking for a tip in front from Hintz. Got through everyone. Held in the zone. Ristolainen. Lay it off for Sanheim. And then Farabee giving away at center. Suter. into the Flyers' end. In deep is Klingberg. He just muscles his way through the larger Sanheim for the puck. Flyers escape. Ristolainen stretched it out. No one home for Farabee. Tail end of the shift. Flyers change. Stars have it. Alexander Radulov in across the line. Down the right wing. Scurries behind the net on his fellow countryman Ivan Provorov. Two of them were talking before the game. Now here's Ellis with a shot. Saved by Khudobin. Number 20 on his many shots.
Repurposed that one a little bit. Good cleanup by the Stars in front of him.
A penalty coming up here as Sagan let go of the stick as he had tripped up Lawton. It wasn't enough to avoid the third power play upcoming here for Philadelphia.
Dallas, number 91, 2-minute liner, tripping.
At times, players call it on themselves by looking overly guilty. And, you know, Tyler tried to get rid of the stick. It was already can opener time. Comes up between the legs. Let's go, but the damage already done. Knocks him off his rails to the power play for the third time go. The Flyers, the Stars, it just feels like for their offense, they need their power play. The Flyers haven't needed their power play as much this season.
They're 0 for 2. They've got 7 shots in those two opportunities. And clearance by the Stars for Philadelphia. This is another crack, and for the Stars, PK, that came in at just 75% efficiency. You gotta be careful of taking these repeat trips to the box, but they clear this one as well.
Well, there's gonna be a penalty here on the Flyers that's gonna negate the final minute and a half of their power play as Couturier goes off.
Philadelphia number 14, 2-minute minor, tripping.
You can almost hear it in his voice. Look at all these trippers out here right now. Turned around, can opener the other way on Esa Lindell, and there you go. Little tit for tat. Some 4-on-4 hockey.
It's one way to kill it off and go 3-for-3 on the kill now for Dallas. And yeah, we'll see what short aside works for both of these clubs. 4-on-4 begins in Philadelphia's territory. Lawton on the draw with Ben. Ben wants Lawton to get a warning. He didn't get a warning on the first one. He jumps on this one. To Konechny, he's been in the crosshairs a couple times as the relief artist. Well, with us, we saw a call back in the first period. Ben tried to go around Konechny forward on that one.
It's impressive when that second guy goes in and wins it like that.
Especially when it's been called in the game a face-off violation.
You expect him to just be a statue in there.
Here's Konechny, anything but on his rush into the zone. His shot goes wide. Klingberg has ice, and the Stars have numbers. 3-on-2, Klingberg, drop pass. Ben, Kosin, shot off the post and out.
I don't think Jones flinched.
Now the other way. It's Lawton, weaves his way in. He's denied by Khudobin, who hangs on. Great chances at both ends on the 4-on-4.
Yeah, Lawton kind of just threw whatever was left on that rush into the tummy of Khudobin, the chance at the other end. I think Jamie wanted to move the puck once he got it. Klingberg gives it to him. He's waiting. He delays. He ripped it against the grain in either tremendous trust by Jones that he had the angle, or just there it is. That's why the pipe's there. Ka-ting.
Terrific look for the Stars captain. Getting cut down at the center logo is Hintz. Play goes on, 40 seconds left in the 4-on-4. In come the Stars. Give and go, Hintz and Haskinen. Pavelski rims it around for Miro Haskinen. 5 points in his last three games. Lindell shot saved by Jones. Now Lindell, Hintz, fake to drop, has it up high. Let a wrister go through. Jones hangs on to it. As we check in with Michelle McMahon.
Yeah, guys, I had a chance to catch up with Luke Glendening on the penalty kill improvements. He said where they were struggling was starting on the faceoff, and he took the first ownership of that category. He said he struggled recently, and that's not an area he struggled with in the past. He also said they've been out of position, a little bit more hesitant, which gives them time to make plays. He feels like that has tightened up a little bit here lately.
Thanks, Michelle. They're 3 for 3 tonight, and they are 4 for 4 so far on the homestand. It was a huge problem point for them on that Canadian road trip, both in terms of the number of penalties they took, 15 times shorthanded on the three-game trip, and then number of power play goals allowed. 5 seconds left in Sagan's penalty. Then it'll be a short power play for the Stars, their first of the night. Thompson is trying to pin it up, already in a PK posture. Stars don't have a ton of time to work with from their own zone. They can only get it as far as the red line. Nate Thompson tosses in from there, maybe one rush for Dallas. Sagan hands back for Suter. Haskinen dumped in. Goes behind the Flyer net, given away. Ben lost his balance for a moment, clanked off the stick. And now here comes Couturier out of the box. So back to full strength on either side. Sagan intercepts. He'll start the counter himself. Tyler Sagan across the line. Feeds it to Ben. To the left wing boards. And his rim in deep got away from Sagan. Klingberg keeps it moving to Lindell. Then turned over. Lawton the poke check, and it's out to center.
Stars still have to find a way to get the puck to the net a little more often with people going there. I mean, they're stuck on 9 shots, and we're already 5 minutes into the second period. And they've had opportunities to send it there.
And 7 shots back in the first, a couple here in the opening 5 minutes of the middle frame. The other way, Giroux walks it in, a shot save made by Hudobin. By contrast, that's the 22nd for Philadelphia.
Boy, a lot of transition here in the second period. Very different than the opening period.
Radulov's got it. Down in the corner, feeds the slot, a chance for Lindell, and he couldn't get it through. The other way, Van Riemsdyk has a trailer. Yandel back to Van Riemsdyk, and he fanned. He had open net if he could have settled it down. Stars will clear. It bounced past Yandel. Worked himself into trouble. Glendening will catch up to a slow-moving puck. Now Giroux. Pickpocketed by Haskinen. Try to snap shot. Blocked by Ellis. Followed up by Hintz. Up high for Suter. Suter's shot goes to Hintz, and he fires a rolling, bouncing puck up high. Back to Hintz, shoveled on the backhand for Robertson. Uses the glove, drops it to himself in the trapezoid. Hintz in the left wing circle. Suter over to Haskinen, right dot, back door, redirected wide. From the corner, Haskinen tried to get it net mouth, could not do so.
Man, a lot of roller hockey from the Flyers on this segment in their zone. They're just drifting around. They weren't stopping and starting. The Stars working the puck.
Pavelski's back in. Lays it off to the corner. Ellis gets there. Moves it to McEwen. Rink wide outlet. Lindblom is tied up momentarily by Hakanpää. Lindblom. And stapled off on the near side boards. Hakanpää will reverse it. Got away from Sekera. Robertson. Part of a battle. Thompson there as well. Puck fought for along the boards. Sekera is the man who escapes with possession. Drops it off for Gurianov. Pass broken up by Provorov. Back to Gurianov. He's got a lane and he walks. Forced wide by Gron. Good defensive play. Now McEwen couldn't clear.
Stars are forcing here now. They're on their forecheck. It's difficult for the Flyers to get clean out of their own zone.
Provorov. Off the stick of Hudobin to the right wing side. Farabee could not connect with Hayes. Off a stick, it's going to stay in the zone. Reach by Sandheim. And shoulder by Sagan. Hayes in the trapezoid. He gets knocked off by Hakanpää. The Stars can come out. Dallas was changing. Pass got through. Possessing is Radulov. Tried to make a dangle around Sandheim. Becomes a turnover. The other way, Lott. Caught by Klingberg. The two of them going to the end boards. Klingberg is able to get the puck and slip it to Suter. Well done.
John's had a good game tonight on both sides of the puck.
Off a stick, a dozen rows deep. Nice catch by a Stars fan wearing the blackouts. Stars have the only goal nearing the midway point in a hockey game. 1-0 Dallas over Philly.
And Riley Tufte had a special moment before this game. He told me it's going to be an awesome moment. I'm going to be taking a deep breath on that first NHL lap and looking up to realize just how cool it is. It's a moment I've dreamed of for so long. That's how he described that first lap in an NHL sweater and what it would feel like. And his family wouldn't miss it for the world. The Tufte family rolls deep. He's got six in the crowd. He's one of six, rather. His dad, Jamie, his mom, Amy, his sister, Tessa, brothers, Gavin and Tanner, all in the crowd tonight, along with his fiance, Morgan, and baby Jack. Not to mention his 6'6" stature, by the way. He played defensive end in high school and football, so that should help with the physicality when Bones was talking about pissing some people off in front of the net of the Flyers, guys.
He's such a likable young man. He's been waiting a long time for this opportunity, his NHL debut. First round pick back in 2016. When they picked him, they said with his size, his skill set out of Minnesota high school, it was a long-term projection. It was supposed to be about 5 years down the road that they expected him to make that really big impact at the NHL level. We're 5 years down the road and he's looking to seize an opportunity. Right side, Hakanpää with a one-timer from the dot. Glendening, the goal scorer, catches up to it. Stars make a partial change. There's Fox with a shot. Big rebound. And it is taken by Philadelphia. Lawton put it off the body of Glendening, and it winds up out of play.
You got to keep in mind that the Flyers played last night in Carolina. And a lot of times when you see teams come out their second game of a back-to-back, they can have an outstanding opening period, and then the legs start to fade on them a little bit. Second periods when your bench is on the other side, they've had extended shifts in their own zone. They've turned the puck over a little bit. It hasn't manifested itself in a lot of shots for the Stars, but territorial advantage here in the second, advantage Dallas.
They keep it in here. Heiskanen faked a shot, then lets a wrister go. It rattles back out to the corner. Clearing attempts. Philadelphia will get it out to neutral ice.
And Bonus has primarily gone with a three-line game here, too, outside of the special teams, which has messed that up probably a little bit. You're forcing, if there are matchups on the other side, a three-line game from a team that played last night, too. And that can wear people out.
Whistle down at the blue line, offside against the Stars. We are 1 second shy of the halfway point of the game.
I mean, we shouldn't be shocked, probably, that these two teams are 1-0 midway through. A couple of clubs that have not been very lubricious with their ability to put the puck in the net. I think this is Tufte's first shift of the second period. Didn't play much in the first. Almost an eyelash off of exactly midway through the game. Little reset.
So he's on the wing. Glendening moves in for Fox. It was kicked out of the circle. The Flyers control it. Glendening will catch up. Tufte goes to the net. Sharp angle shot at the outside of the post. Provorov starts it out for Braun. Braun has had an increased role to start the season with Ryan Ellis getting hurt early on in the season, just three games in. The top pairing was supposed to be Ellis and Provorov. Hasn't had a chance to get going with Ellis making his return. They're kind of easing him back into action, and Braun's looked very good opposite Provorov this year. McEwen, the reach from Peterson. Tyler Seguin will chip it in. Peterson chasing after. Peterson, a little stick low. Provorov went down. Play goes on. Sagan's got it in front for Radulov. Got a piece, but not all of it. Atkinson steamrolled in front of the Dallas bench by Seguin. Center ice, Heiskanen is on it. As the Stars touch up, they'll get it in deep. Jones peels it off the end boards for Provorov. He's the time on ice leader for Philadelphia. Plays about 24 and a half minutes a night. Hudobin cuts it off in the trapezoid behind his net. Heiskanen turns off contact, calmly stays with it, skates away from Farabee. Find Seguin, sidestep connected. Stars are in. Chip down to the corner. Good work in the corners. Michael Ralph will now Ben intercepts. Goes through a corner of the crease. And he goes to hit that. He gets a lot of them. Ristolainen and Raffle.
And that's a man's game down there.
Now Lund staying with it through center. He'll just tap in on the back.
Been pounding with the forecheck a little more. Containment off of it.
Ducked in by the Stars. Ellis to Yandel. Hockenbach keeps it for Robertson. Walks it to the high slot. Stays with it. Left circle in front. Redirection. Save. Score! Ropey hits. Goals in two straight. And he doubles the Dallas lead.
Well, this goal was set up by the shift prior to it. Ben and company went in and went blasting the Flyers in their own zone. They went right back to the dump and bump. They threw it in deep, got it back again off a turnover. Nice little pinch by Hockenpah. Great work by Robertson. Man, can he dangle. And two guys to the front of the net. Exuberation from Ropey hints. Funny how things happen. You get a goal. Now he's got goals in back-to-back games. Now the Stars have a little breathing room within this game tonight.
He went 11 games. He was one of the leaders in shots on goal. Could not buy a goal. He was hitting posts. He was getting stoned by netminders. He was doing everything but turn on the red light. He gets that one the other night. He gets this one here. The Stars double their lead. The assist to Robertson and Gurianov. Yandel, shot punched away by the blocker of Hudobin. 7 minutes and counting left in the second. Nearly a giveaway. Stars will get it out of harm's way. Riley Tufte.
Not the time to get cute down there with puck movement.
Bounces into the Dallas end board. Suter goes there with Lindblom. The right wing side. Philly on the attack. Comes to the near side boards. A poke check from Klingberg. Starts the attack. Left wing side. It's Peterson. Lost the handle. Knocked off his stick by Thompson, who comes away with it. Nate Thompson finds McEwen. Shoot it in from the center line. Peterson. Now here's Radulov. Across the Flyer line for Sagan. Back off Radulov in deep, wrist the line. And now Thompson. Up ahead. Chips in by Lindblom. Hudobin has it in his glove. And he was waiting to see if he could hand it off to a teammate. Winds up hanging on for the whistle. Stars had a 1-0 lead since the intermission break. That changes to two, courtesy of Ropey Hintz, who has tallies in consecutive games.
Late second period at American Airlines Center. Stars ahead of the Flyers 2-0. Our Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant marquee matchup tonight. We haven't seen the block horns like in past, but 35-year-old Alexander Radulov and 24-year-old Ivan Provorov. Radulov second in time on ice amongst Stars forwards this season, and Provorov leads Philly in that category year after year. They've had some epic battles with one another in past meetings between these two teams. It's kind of out of nowhere.
Shot from the blue line, Ristolainen is stopped. Now Ben, handoff left side, a trailer as Gurianov goes to Haskinen in one motion, got the shot away, and Jones made the save. Puck deflects up and out of play.
Boy, the Stars are outplaying the Flyers here now. It's pretty obvious. Philly can't get any kind of a forecheck. Time in the zone. We haven't talked about Hudobin for eons in the game. And lines are starting to dictate with the give the puck up, get it back again, create in the offensive zone. The Flyers look weary. The Stars look like they've found their legs and their swerve a little bit in this one.
Offensive zone faceoff, one cleanly. It's Klingberg. Shot redirection just wide of the post. Pavelski, left circle, slapped back wide by Suter. Klingberg to Pavelski. past the reach of Hintz. And Robertson in front. He was looking to get it back there quickly and dangerously. It was knocked away. Provorov didn't clear initially. Then it's held in top of the zone by Suter. Ryan Suter gets it back in deep. Suter centering feed. Wanted Hintz camped out top of the crease. Taken instead by Brassard.
Starting to see from the Flyers, basically, they get to center ice, get it in deep, and get their change in because they're spending so much time in their own zone and chasing the Stars around.
Sanheim is hit by Hintz. Robertson. Hintz in front of the Dallas bench. Will wind one in. Head off for a change. Robertson sends it to Glendening. He tried to backhand. Didn't come off his stick cleanly. Then he paid for it on a check. Ristolainen had to avoid the incoming check from Glendening. Van Riemsdyk, rink wide, drew across the line, dropped it off, back to Van Riemsdyk, shot block, follow up, he got caught, and it rolled innocently in, scooped up by Hudobin. Under 4.5 to go in the second, Stars with one in the first, one in the second, they got a 2-0 lead in Dallas.
Finland native enjoys the Killers, likes to cook and play tennis in his free time. And he idolized Brian Rafalski, interestingly enough, growing up. I was curious, it wasn't a Finn. So I asked the story there. He said he played in Helsinki when he was growing up and he was their top right-handed defensive guy. And he said, I want to be just like him, guys.
Just a little bit taller than Brian Rafalski. I didn't know if cooking and tennis at the same time was the pastime or if that was a two-part answer. Ellis to Provorov, out to block. It was Raffel. Michael Raffel, more than 500 games with the Flyers in his career. He played him twice after the deadline deal to Washington last season. Entertaining story, he said. He was asked, is it fun to play against all those guys you knew? He said the first time it definitely wasn't. We lost. Smiled, said the second time was a lot of fun. Squeezed out an overtime win.
The last time the Stars played the Flyers, he was the fourth line center iceman on their squad. And, you know, they had some good teams. They felt like after last year, though, they needed change. Their internal community. They were very active in the offseason. There was a bit of a rot going on. They're trying to push back in this game a little bit. The Stars have completely taken it over.
Scoreline is showing that with a multi-goal lead for the Stars. It's the first time the Stars have had a multi-goal lead since opening night in Madison Square Garden. Ristolainen and a shot blasted high and wide. Couturier sends it around. Ristolainen was looking for a tip. Hit the body of Drew and stayed there. Good pressure here by the Flyer. Sanheim is low. Wrap around. Back door. It hit traffic in front. It was rolling into the crease and then bobbled. And Hudobin looked like he had a chance. It wound up in the net and scored.
That's unbelievable.
He picks up the puck and chucks it against the backboards in frustration. It looked for sure like he was going to be able to put the glove on it and secure it.
Sometimes goaltenders try to smother the puck and a defender's stick fouls it up. I think it was Ristolainen who eventually came in there and chunked this thing. Hudobin turned around, never got his hand on it. It was bumped right back in and passed him by one of the Stars goal scorers, Luke Glendening, thinking he could just nudge it back to his netminder from up above. Hudobin made a sprawling save with one arm, stopped it again with the hand, and then the simple nudge beat Anton. There goes the shutout bid. There goes the two-goal lead.
What a save before all that, and then what a crazy sequence for Glendening. Where he's supposed to be, the defensive forward, and just bumped it with a little more than he wanted to and a little more than Hudobin was ready for. Good work by Peterson and Brock scores! Clanked off Sagan and in. And after that crazy goal at one end, Dallas gets it right back to restore the two-goal lead.
Well, they go right back on the forecheck and earn the puck back again, which they've done repeatedly here in the second period. Man, nice dangling, swerving by Peterson. Kept his eyes up, throws it toward the net. I don't know that it ever got Sagan's stick blade. It might have. Certainly went off the defender's skate and sailed past Martin Jones. What a play by Peterson. They have three past Jones in the game. And what an answer. What a clap back by the Stars here.
26 seconds after the Flyers' goal. Now a turnaround chance, Konechny. And that almost went in far side. Before the game, Rick Bonus was talking about getting that save and that goal and how it's plagued the Stars when they've needed it at critical points in the hockey game. That felt like a very critical point in the hockey game after the Flyers really couldn't generate much of anything recently. And pass here as Sanheim gets rolled over. And they get it immediately back.
Well, the impressive thing for me is that guys that you don't expect to be taking the body consistently are leaning into some people here tonight. I mean, Roope Hintzman physical. You just saw Robertson hammer Sanheim at the blue line. Little bit of offense, but it's their forechecking. They talked about it prior to the last game. It was spotty in that one. Here tonight, it took a period for them to get going with it. And now against a club that's been on their heels and has a little bit of fatigue in their group, the Stars have mauled them here in the second period with their forecheck.
Deflected out of play, and we'll get another faceoff.
Playing harder tonight and being rewarded for it. And period to period, just like a different event in this season for the Stars. And for them to turn what has been a cadaverous middle frame into a success, maybe a major turning point for them this year.
Here's Raffle, turnaround shot deflected. Is in the trapezoid. Jamie bent tight angle. Blocker saved by Jones. Raffle. His pass to Ben. Up high, Haskinen. Banning was Lindell, so he'll keep it wide. And then a penalty upcoming. Hayes cross-checked Raffle. Haskinen keeps it alive. Touched by the Flyers and the Stars, who have one power play in the game, but it only lasted 30 seconds. Will go on the man advantage.
Well, they draw this one because of their dogged work deep in the Flyer zone again.
Philadelphia 13, minor penalty, cross check.
Hayes, who hasn't played until this game this season, this is the nouveau call in the league, and he got him right in the lower lumbar and behind the net. Stars power play is on a run. We talked about it in the spotlight tonight that they've got five straight games scoring with it. Been about half their offense. They haven't needed it to build the lead tonight, but they can all but put this thing away with a tally here.
Final 2 minutes of the second period. Stars are on the power play for the remainder of it, unless they can get that goal. They'd love to add another one here to what's been a very strong second period. Klingberg, pass for Hintz, drop pass. Radulov back for Klingberg.
That's
Klingberg
a penalty.
Is tripped up. The referees disagree. The crowd here agrees. Here's a shot. Save. Jones, and he's able to secure it.
And that looked like a blatant trip. It looked like Couturier just stuck his leg out and tripped John Klingberg. Just because they're shorthanded doesn't mean you don't call it. John's feeling him in. He's right. I was shocked they didn't call this. I mean, that's tripping.
Yeah. And we've seen five on threes, both in Stars games and league wide. Flyers got one last night. The Stars were shorthanded two men a couple times on the Canadian road trip. Flyers get away with one there. Remains a Stars power play, but it's cleared by Philadelphia.
1 minute remaining in the second period.
Miro Heiskanen got the power play goal last time out. He's got the puck here. He has two of them, tied for the team lead with Joe Pavelski. Rimmed around, Gurianov, tied up with Lindblom, gets the puck, then off his stick, not cleared. Heiskanen near wing. Rink wide for Sagan. Left circle, a shot, change directions. Hit Jones, and he smothers it.
You're in trouble with your own guys from time to time as a netminder. That went off Ristolainen, Jones' defenseman, and into his torso. He's out there. Oh, those are the ones that just kill you as a netminder. You're like, you're not helping. That doesn't help.
Anton Khudobin, 200 feet away, agrees with the one that eluded him earlier in the period. Good fight for Robertson. He gets hooked off by Couturier.
Man, Couturier can do anything he wants out there, apparently. That looked like hooking.
Running out of time to make it a 5-on-3. There's only 25 seconds left in the power play. 10 seconds in the period. Pavelski gets knocked down, this time by Thompson. The Stars will work it rink wide. Time is out. And the period comes to a close. A good one, a needed one for the Stars.
Well, look, they survived the first period because of Anton Khudobin. In the second period, they won all the races to pucks, all the physical battles, everything. A lucky goal against was the only blemish in that middle period. The Flyers kept hope alive with that kill at the end of the period, but Stars are in control of this hockey game, it feels like now.
And it's two of the more dangerous guys on this Stars lineup who have the second period goals. Roope Hintz has goals in back-to-back games. Tyler Seguin also on the board for his team-leading fifth. 3-1, Dallas has the lead. We're 40 minutes through. The intermission report is on the way next.
By Baylor Scott and White Health, changing healthcare for the better. And by Chevrolet, Chevy drives Texas. Find new roads.
Stars take a multi-goal lead into the third period here at American Airlines Center. 3-1 over the Flyers. And a reminder, fans, you can host your child's birthday party at your local Children's Health Star Center community ice rink. Multiple packages are available at dallasstars.com/starcenters. We welcome you back in here as the Stars go for the finish with a 3-1 lead over the Flyers. But before we get to the third period, Razor, time to take a look at our Blue Cross Blue Shield legends of the game.
It's Hall of Fame weekend in Toronto, and a former Stars draft pick is going in the hall. It's COVID delayed this year, but Jerome Iginla, who was drafted by the Stars 11th overall back in 1995, traded 6 months later for Joe Nieuwendyk. What a deal that was. Iggy went on to capture two goal-scoring titles and an Art Ross with the Calgary Flames. Of course, Nieuwendyk, the 1999 playoff MVP with the Stars. The ultimate win-win of a trade when you consider both guys end up in the Hall of Fame, both guys left indelible marks on their franchises after they moved away. Of course, Joe won a cup with the Flames before he left there in 89.
It really does feel like the barometer that every single trade is held up to when you want to talk about a positive that both franchises would do it again in a heartbeat. Stars trying to get back into the win column. They have themselves in terrific position. You see the conversation taking place before the puck drop at center ice to open up the third period. Dallas will carry over 18 seconds of power play time.
I can remember back in the day when Sergei Zubov was with the Stars, another Hall of Famer. They used to come out with a situation like this. I think they called it 52 Skidoo. And they had a play for when they won the draw. Zubov would just pierce the ice. Nieuwendyk or somebody would cut into the middle. Madonna. And they could score off of a face-off win at the beginning of the period on their power play.
They don't have a lot of time to work with. The draw is sent into the Flyer zone. And Provorov will get there. Turn it over to Raffel. Backdoor feed and a chance. Gurionov, there it was. Turned aside by Jones. That's a huge one. Hayes comes out of the box. Dallas got their look. I don't know if that's how they drew it up, but they got their look. And a great one at that. 5-on-5 hockey as Suter backpedals. So Dallas is 0 for 2 on the power play. The Flyers are 0 for 3 on the power play. Ristolainen over to Sanheim. And then ahead for Atkinson off his stick. Khudobin will just bump it for Haskinen. Wasn't on the same page. Haskinen was going behind the net. The puck went to the sidewall. Then the Stars turn it over. Work to Ristolainen. A shot, and he missed it. Short side.
He can stimulate the biscuit, though, man, when he leans into it.
Farabee circling the zone. Right back to Ristolainen. There's another shot, this time kept low, and grazed off skates to the corner. Ristolainen keeps it moving for Hayes. Off of a cutting Ristolainen, who's been everywhere on this ship.
That's a penalty.
Indeed it is. Farabee was setting a pick and also went high on Roope Hintz, who gets up and in frustration gives Farabee a whack across the shins. Let's see if there's more coming to the original call.
Well, Roope got up and smacked him in the shin pads. Whether they're going to get that or not, I mean, this is a pick. I've seen more violent picks than that. But it's interference. He backs into it. He knew what he was doing. And I think he caught Roope right in the jaw. And Hintz got up incensed. Tribute to the type of penalties that you really, as a group, always want to cash in on, right? Violent, unnecessary one like that. Make them pay. Build a 3-goal lead. Milk it home.
Third power play of the game for the Stars. They have power play goals in 5 straight games. They would love to extend that streak, and if they can, like you said, you have your largest margin with time running short. Gurionov will bring it in. Feed it back to Suter. Didn't connect cleanly.
What a chance for Denis Gurionov to make it 4-1 on the first portion of the power play set to begin this third period.
He's out there with Ben and Sagan. Haskinen and Suter, 2 defensemen set. Not much working here for the Stars as it's cleared down the glass all the way behind the net, where Khudobin will put it on a platter as the new unit out there for the Stars.
Well, that clearing attempt barely stayed in the rink, caught the top part of the glass.
This one does not, but it's a deflection, so no delay of game. It was at neutral ice. 1:08 left in the Farabee interference call.
Well, Jones made that sparkling stop on Gurionov. The Stars changed the point of attack, and bam, right in the wheelhouse, left shot, right wing side. And you know, Denis Gurionov, since that scratch, the healthy scratch, he played 3 games, only taken 3 shots or hit the net 3 times. He did score on one of them. That was basically a tap-in on the power play in Calgary from Haskinen. Had some chances in the game, instrumental in Hintz's goal.
John Klingberg has it, moves it to the right side for Pavelski. He's cut off right in front of the Philadelphia bench, but it wasn't clean across the blue line, whistled offside.
Hard to believe that John Klingberg still doesn't have a power play point. You know, when you consider that the Stars power play came into play tonight sitting 3rd best in the NHL. If you'd have told me they're going to be 3rd best and John's not going to have a point yet, I said, no way. Speaks to the depth that they have in this side of their special teams.
Here's Hintz, left circle, a shot, save, rebound in front, score! His 3rd power play goal of the year. The Stars have another power play tally, and they've got their largest lead of the night.
Oh, there's got to be massive satisfaction for Roope Hintz as he gets it fed to him by Radulov. They create the rebound opportunity. Hintz tried to beat him short side, followed up as he beat Sanheim to the puck, and Joe Pavelski, there's what, 16 power play goals in his last like 70 games, if you go back to last season's 56, and now this year. He's been a master of that side of the Stars special teams, and they do strike again. Six games in a row with a power play goal.
It's the first time since February of 2020, just before the COVID pause, that the Stars have scored power play goals in six consecutive games. And Joe Pavelski also has a personal six-game point streak after netting the tap. So the Stars do cash in. They've got a 4-1 lead, 17 minutes left for the Flyers. And now you're really testing a Philadelphia team that played last night, traveled to get here, and they're facing a sizable gap on the scoreboard.
Well, all those things, Josh, and the fact they haven't scored four goals in their last seven games. They've been stuck on two a lot, and you're probably asking a lot if you're Alain Vigneault and their coaching staff.
It's amazing when you give up nothing, scoring woes, they don't really affect you. They don't seem as large or not as magnified because the Flyers are putting together such a good record. But you're right, six of the last seven games, they've been held to two or fewer. It's not usually a common recipe for success. They found a way to get it done with exceptional netminding. Gurianov spins his way in. Ben was waiting for in the circle. Instead, it's wrapped back around. Martin Jones was off to such a tremendous start to his Philadelphia career. He stopped 95 of 100 shots in three starts heading into this game. The Stars have four goals on 21 shots tonight.
Can't help but think back to his NHL beginning with the LA Kings. It was the same thing. Then the Stars came along. Poof, went the balloon.
Akinpah to Raffle. He'll move it to Sekera. Four across the line for Dallas. Gurianov put it towards the net and steered aside by Jones. Jones with a very similar offseason and stretch for Braden Holtby. A couple of tough seasons, and they were both bought out from their respective clubs. Looking to refine their form, signed matching one-year, $2 million show-me deals on the first day of free agency. Off his stick, and Provorov will grab it on the end boards to Ryan Ellis. Cut off by Robertson. Roope Hintz stays with it. Two-point game for him. He assisted on the most recent tally, scored back in the second period. McEwen is bumped down by Lindell, ushered forward. Haskinen will lift it back out to center. Clock continues to move. It's a friend of the Stars. That hasn't been the case all too often as it ticks towards the end of regulation this season. Lindell the lob. Riley Tufte in his NHL debut. Does he have some magic down there at ice level?
Well, it's a nice luxury when you're up by three that you can probably try to get the youngster a little more ice time here in the third period. Let him get a better feel for the NHL when it's real in the regular season.
It has been spot duty here in his first game, a shot high and wide. He's played just around 4 minutes.
The other guy that got called up has had a bite in this game, Jacob Peterson.
There is a arm up, penalty coming. As the Stars, Alexander Radulov will go to the box. The Stars on the board. Power play goal for the sixth straight game. And guess who, indeed? Joe Pavelski, the latest. It's 4-1 Dallas.
There's the Anton Khudobin show as he rappelled puck after puck after puck. Stars were outshot 19-7 in the first period. Even when they thought they scored, he broke their hearts. What a performance. Been mostly a spectator since the opening period, but they might have been in big, big trouble here again tonight without his ability to kick a lot of pucks back as he got strafed and peppered, especially with those two penalties they took in the opening period. They took another one here. He might have to get busy again.
hooking against Radulov. Power play chance number four for the Flyers, and you have to imagine that if they have any designs of getting back in this one, this is a power play they have to cash in on. Giroux playing catch up high with Yandel, then goes low, backhand off his stick, falls in the slot. Foxit trying to stay with it. Khudobin steps behind the net to keep it moving. Hakanpaa, chance to clear on the backhand, he didn't. Giroux held it in. This time Khudobin leaves for his defenseman, and this time Lindell does it himself and clears it all the way down.
It's always a tough play for a defenseman. They're being hounded by a guy. They're on their backhand. They're trying to elevate it past the guy who 100% is pinching at the blue line. They get a second crack at it, and down it goes.
Giroux, near side, to Yandel, back to Giroux. Again, Yandel straight away. Giroux, top of the right circle. His backhand pass, Yandel keeps it in the zone. Shot, punched aside by Khudobin. Loose in the corner for a moment, then wrapped around where Giroux awaits it. Over halfway through this power play for the Flyers. Farabee, Van Riemsdyk, who has credit for the Flyers' goal. It was pushed in by the Stars themselves. Michael Roffel, good stick here, and he deflects it all the way down.
And that is a non-confident and very static power play that they've rolled out repeatedly here tonight, and the Stars have been very good with their penalty killing.
Across the blue line, Hayes dropped off Brassard. Ellis at the point. 20 seconds left on the power play. Hayes. Far circle, up high for Provorov, back for Hayes. Provorov, one-timer, score! With 9 seconds left on the Radulov penalty, the Flyers' power play strikes in, snaps a 13-opportunity drought, and gets Philadelphia within a pair.
Man, they had everything they wanted, too. Jamie Benn and Luke Glendening are up top trying to keep that shooting lane. They're in the I formation. The issue was Khudobin could never find it past the body of Brassard right in front of him. Not a big guy trying to look around. You need to get the block. It's a perfectly placed shot by Provorov to get past the shot blockers. And with Hadobin's inability to get his eyes on it, it sailed into the twine and made this game a little more interesting than it was a few seconds ago.
It's Provorov's first of the year. He, the last couple of years, had been good for about a point every other game. He only had 2 assists in a dozen games heading into this one. We documented the scoring struggles and certainly the power play scoring struggles for Philadelphia. So you see a lot of guys with sub-career average numbers. He's one of them, but he gets a goal here, and it certainly makes the final dozen minutes of this one a lot more interesting.
Well, it pumps life into the Flyers, which they didn't have. And now you're going to have to earn it.
Khudobin will keep it moving. Stars still very much in the driver's seat. They've got a 4-2 lead. But this feels like a critical series of shifts here to see how both clubs respond after the latest tally. And the first clean one of the night for Philly to beat Anton Khudobin.
I feel kind of bad for Alexander Radulov. That's just his second penalty of the season. He used to get in all kinds of trouble with that in previous seasons.
Here he clears it out. Peterson tries to poke it to himself away from Braun. Goes down, gets back up. He's fun to watch.
Well, he's smart. He anticipates so well. You can understand where the play is going to go, how to use angles. That's the thing that's impressed me the most from a guy coming from the big pond. He understands angles on the small sheet over here, or the narrower rank in North America.
That's such a good mental approach as well to take that assignment down to the American Hockey League. He scored the first goal of the year, and he made that jump that no one saw coming straight to the Stars opening night roster. He has been impressive wherever he's been in North America the last few months as we head down to Michelle McMahon.
Yeah, guys, I asked him, Jacob Peterson, in terms of what the two biggest things he worked on in his game and the AHL. He said, number one, shooting first. I had a tendency when the last time I was up here to pass first. And secondly, he wants to be more aggressive all around. That was the feedback he was getting, in particular on the wall battles. And he seems to be doing a good job of that here tonight, guys.
Yeah, he sure does. Had 5 points in 6 AHL games. That third goal, the one that the Stars answered right back, is still being credited to Sagan. So Peterson getting the assist on.
And Raffel and Giroux are at one another.
Here is Yandel with a shot. Glove saved by Udobin. He controlled the rebound and covered it up well past the top of the crease. About half a period to go. Stars with a 4-2 lead over the Flyers. Dallas looking for their first regulation win of the season. 10 huge minutes to go.
Stars have just surrendered a goal to the Flyers and a gritty blue-collar shift by Sagan, Peterson and company. Great pinch by Sekera on the boards. Vision and hands from Jacob Peterson, and Tyler Sagan's getting rewarded for going to the other team's net repeatedly. Once again, that was a big, big goal a half a minute after they surrendered the first goal of the game to the Flyers.
Raffel dumps it in. Glendening charges after it in the right wing corner. He opened the scoring. He's been directly involved in two goals in the game, one for and one against on the miscommunication with Hudobin. He and Raffel, two of the veteran newcomers, they're going to have a lot to discuss here facing their former teams in consecutive home games. Detroit will be in town on Tuesday night. Ristolainen for Farabee, bounces in. Hudobin will just calmly leave it for his defenseman Klingberg. Off of Robertson to negate icing. Jones drifts behind the net, feeds it to the corner. It's picked off there. The Stars, Pavelski, hints is between the circles. No passing lane there. He tried to just spin one towards the net, and it was knocked away by Braun. Haskin into hints. Touch pass Provorov, a race for the puck. Braun was there just a shade ahead of Pavelski. Two longtime teammates in San Jose. Dallas looking to win it right back. Sagan's pass didn't connect with Pavelski. Brassard forced to retreat. Flyers with possession, but trapped underneath their end line. Just the fifth home game of the season. It was a road-heavy slate. It's now very much tilted home-heavy for the next few weeks. The crowd making some noise, trying to urge the Stars over the finish line. They are 1-2-1 here on home ice. It was opening night against the LA Kings in overtime when they got their lone victory. Ellis for Sanheim. Now back for Ellis. Clock under 8 to go in regulation. Giveaway and the Stars will charge in. It's Radulov. Right wing circle. A backhand still on his tape behind the net. Slip to Ben and a shot saved by Jones.
All started with that overskate by Sanheim and neutralized. They're going to have to get their D involved.
Giroux with a shot, and that one found glass. Jumped away from Van Riemsdyk. Diving play, not cleared. Held by Sanheim. Ben takes it away from Giroux. The two captains meeting. Ben will use the glass this time and clear it. Ristolainen shoots it in. Hudobin takes a look. With a forehand suitor, reversed it back for Haskinen. To the point, not out. Funneled back low. Hudobin's been very active from his net.
He's been good. He's handled it smart. He hasn't tried to do too much. Very confident, patient. Looked at his options and moved it.
That one clipped the linesman sitting on the Stars bench, and then it was blown dead offside at the blue line.
Stars had a couple of opportunities to get the puck out. It was kind of a flippy play by Haskin at first. Came right back at him. It was when Sanheim overskated the puck, allowed Radulov to work the puck on his backhand. So good. What a perfect little thread-the-needle pass. Set up Ben in front of the net. Again, he tried to go against the grain on short side on Jones. That time got stoned earlier in the game. He hit pipe.
Ben's got points in three of the last four games. Here's Fox up. He's got a man streaking ahead, Glendening. Stick lift on Provorov. They cancel each other out. Now it's Fox in front. Raffel on the doorstep. Getting knocked down, just bulldozed in the trapezoid. It was Braun. Fox led that charge. The other way, Farabee. He'll bank it to the corner. Atkinson, back low for Farabee. Ron, the defenseman, had stepped down, lost his stick on another check from Foxa. The star steal. Here's Haskinen in across the line. Haskinen, wrist shot, loved by Jones. He's got time if he wants to drop it, and he does. So that'll keep things moving with under six to play in the third period. Teams have traded goals here in the final frame. Stars still have a two-goal lead. Konechny with a shot. Save Hudobin. The shots in the first period were 19 to 7, favoring Philadelphia. All of a sudden, they are close to even in that category. Stars really flipped things around at that first intermission. They have been in control for most of the game since. Taken away by Dallas, sprung ahead. Peterson left circle, a shot. He was looking far post and just pushed it wide.
Boy, the Flyers, as the game has moved along, have started to turn the puck over more and more. It's what tired teams do a lot. Minds are weary, legs are weary. It's allowed the Stars to have the puck a lot in the last two periods of the game.
Lindell takes it from his netminder. Ellis goes down with Peterson at the point. Aerial leads out to center. Van Riemsdyk back to Ellis, upright this time, and he will shovel it rink wide to the corner. Lindell rims it around. No icing here. Provorov pursued by Radulov. Radulov gets a stick in there to pester. Provorov pulls away with it. Comes all the way back with speed. Coast to coast. Provorov beyond the net and rolled off his tape as he tried to center. Now the Stars in the other direction. It's Ben. Has it cutting Robertson. A trailing Lindell. Ben shoots. Saved by Jones.
Needs to go somewhere other than short side on the blocker.
0 for 3. 2 by Jones. 1 by the pipe. Captain's got it again. This time centers for Robertson and a chance. Saved by Jones. Ben keeps it in. Robertson, left circle. Centering pass, loose. Gurianov denied after it stopped in the skates of Provorov. What a look for Gurianov.
The Flyers just look like table hockey players there who are just spinning in place. Nothing left in the tank. And their netminder to the rescue. Well, our Baylor Scott and White Health game diagnosis tonight. Speaking of goaltenders to the rescue, go back to the opening frame. And it was the Doby Show. They were outshot by a large margin, 19-7. He stoned them repeatedly. Somehow the Stars came out of the opening frame up 1-0. Nice patient play by John Klingberg to find the stick blade of Luke Glendinning, his fourth of the season. Second period, Stars got their act together and dominated play. Hintz made it 2-0. His open shutout bid was spoiled by a real daffy own goal as Glendinning was trying to bump it back to his netminder. But a half a minute later, after that ugly, awarded to JVR, Sagan on a real sugary sweet feed by Jacob Peterson restored that lead. In the third, they trade power play goals. Pavelski from the goal mouth on a rebound, and then Provorov late in the Flyer power play with a dart from the blue line past some shot blockers and a screen to Anton Hudobin. And that is it for offense in the game. You know, I remember earlier this year, teams and coaches were talking about the Stars heading into the game, about how big and how physical they are. And I would scratch my head a little bit. I was like, I don't really see them as a big physical team. And tonight they played like a big physical team. And they punished a road-weary club in the Philadelphia Flyers. The forecheck instrumental in half of their goals in the game. And just all over the rink, they out-muscled the Flyers a lot, outskated them as the game moved along. Full marks for a two-goal lead with 4 minutes to go.
Part of that compete that Rick Bowness was looking for. They try and claw their way out of what's been a tough seven-game stretch. Just one win over that time. And it looked like a team that felt the urgency for as much as you can in a 13th game of an 82-game season. Here's Lawton. Good job to hustle down and negate icing, but the Stars were there. Proper support, clear it out to center. Suter uses the knee, hacky sack style at center ice. In with speed, connects. He tries to turn off the circle and knocked away there by Hintz. Under 3.5 to go in the third period. With a two-goal gap, keep an eye on Martin Jones. Alain Vigneault is already standing on the Flyers bench, ready to summon his netminder. There he goes with over 3 minutes to play. He hits the bench, extra attacker out there for the Flyers. Empty net. Provorov has to reverse it.
Stars worked on a lot of this yesterday in practice. Perhaps a little foreshadowing.
Dumped in. To the right point, Ellis holds it in. Ryan Ellis feeds it Couturier. Outer hash marks near side. He'll bank it back across and terrific setup for Van Riemsdyk, and he just fanned on it. It was quickly set up by Giroux. Still set up 6-on-5. Couturier goes low. Van Riemsdyk put it through the legs on the backhand. Past everybody. Iced by the Stars. And the whistle comes with 2:27 to go.
Well, two high forehand setups by the Flyers. The first one, the Billiards play off the back of the boards in behind the net. Couturier on the half wall sent it in behind. That was the second one with the little clear things out, put it through the goal mouth. Prior to that, a beauty.
Stars defensemen have been out there for over a minute and a half in Klingberg and Suter. It's Konechny down low. He'll bank it around for Hayes. Cut off in the corner. Clearing attempt. Ristolainen keeps it in. Over to Yandle. Yandle to Atkinson. Up and down the left wing. Surveying options. Off a stick to Glendening. Here's a chance for Fox the entire way. He buries it. Into the empty net. Radek Foxa. 150-foot dagger. And the Stars have a 5-2 lead.
Well, the centering feed was full of risk and marginally unnecessary. And Stars have held their ice in their own zone defensively well in the game. And a yawning cage at the other end nailed by Foxa. Good to get him back in the goal column. Stars with their highest output offensively this season. And that puts the Flyer netminder, Martin Jones, back in the cage.
Foxa gets his second of the year, his first since opening night. Snaps an 8-game point drought. Here comes Pavelski in, and a save made by Jones. Netminder back in there, but the Stars offense wasn't quite ready to turn off the switch.
No, they're rolling. They're playing to their potential here. It took a while to get going. It wasn't like they came out of the gates on their toes tonight. They survived an opening period where the Flyers outplayed them by a pretty healthy margin, but once they got going, no stopping them.
Another shot off the draw, Radulov. Jones has seen some work during what typically is mop-up time when you return from the bench.
It's amazing how the Flyers repeatedly through the years have become the star slump buster. They don't meet each other all that much. Talked about it in the Taco Bell take tonight. Get more into it when I get a second.
Maybe that was the problem last year. Needed a date with Philadelphia. Down low. It's grabbed by Ellis. Sekera has pinched his way down the left boards. Across the line, Provorov. Shot in and out of the glove of Hudobin. Jones is staying put between the pipes as you'd expect. 5-2 Stars with just a shade over a minute to go. As a happy chorus rains down from the crowd here at American Airlines Center. Game two of a 3-game homestand. They welcome Detroit on Tuesday. This is icing against the Flyers.
So they were 1-7-1 to start the season in October of 2019, and then they beat the Flyers 4-1 in Philly. In March of 2018, they had lost 8 straight. And then they beat them in overtime 3-2 here on home ice. You go back to 2013, they lost 5 of 7. And then they beat the Flyers 5-1 here on home ice. And they had one win in their last seven prior to this one tonight. And it looks like they're headed to victory, no doubt.
One more meeting this year is January 24th.
Well, let's hope they don't need that again.
I was going to say, keep your eye. The antenna's got to be up those first few weeks of 2022. Half a minute to go. Hudobin with a save. He got the premature whistle. It snuck through. It was tucked into the empty net by McEwen. No goal as the whistle came early. The Stars get away with a break there.
Well, it would almost be appropriate if he gave up three. He's given up three in every game, as great as he's played tonight. And sometimes it's the position of the official and the intent to blow the whistle and the fact that it would have been merely cosmetic anyway. With the Stars up by three with less than half a minute to go, but it would have been back-to-back games for McEwen with tallies.
It's always a tough call when those happen, like you said.
Not that tough when you're the netminder, I'll tell you.
The refs, they just go off the perspective they have down at ice level. It's easier to swallow in a situation like this where it doesn't change anything except the box score. McEwen out there, though, he's looking for a little bit of poetic justice. 13 seconds to go. Shot by Yandle. Redirects up high off the netting. One what should be final whistle with 9 seconds to go. And just a needed night for the Stars.
Yeah. Bit of an unfettered finish to it here. But, yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter which way you did it here tonight. They did it in a lot of different ways, though, which is probably the best part of this. Goaltender was fantastic. Special teams were better than theirs. All four lines instrumental in it, or three and a half anyway.
It'll move behind the net. The final seconds tick off. The Stars came into the game needing a win. They leave getting one. A big night for Anton Hudobin to set the table. Dallas picks up their fifth victory of the season, their first in regulation time.
Well, I think they checked a lot of boxes tonight. You know, they played faster, they played together, they played harder, they did their jobs, they initiated all over the ice once they got going, and they got a sublime performance from their netminder early to allow them to find their legs and get going against the Flyers.
31 saves for Anton Hudobin. He picks up his third win of the year. The Stars' offense provides more than enough. Five goals from five different players. Another night with a power play goal. A perfect night and a perfect finish for the Stars, who badly needed a win. For Darryl Ray, Michelle McMahon, our terrific crew, I'm Josh Bogorod. 5-2, Stars beat the Flyers. Stick around. The postgame show is next.